The term pixel becomes quite confusing when talking about different resolutions, since the size of a pixel changes. This is why units of color are sometimes referred to as dots, and their size is inferred by the resolution. Under standard settings, the NTSC Super NES will output an image that is 256 by 224 pixels in size. This corresponds to a progressive picture that consists of 224 scan lines with 256 dots per scan line. Progressive just means that the image is not split into two fields, it only uses one. Each frame, the next image is placed exactly on top of where the previous one was. This results in a fairly smooth video at the cost of only using half of the available scan lines. When interlaced mode is enabled, the image is displayed on a different field every other frame. So the picture will be drawn on the even-numbered scan lines first, then the odd-numbered scan lines, then the even, then the odd, etc. This would result in the image looking kind of shaky, since the whole thing is shifting up and down by one scan line every frame. This is what interlaced mode for modes 0 through 4 and 7 looks like. To actually display a different image on the two fields, the developer would need to code that in manually. However, in background modes 5 and 6, interlaced mode acts a little bit different. The resolution of the image is actually doubled to 448 lines. Instead of drawing the same picture shifted vertically to each field, the even and odd scan lines are divided up and distributed to their corresponding field. Due to the persistence of vision, it would appear to the human eye that the entire image is being displayed at once, but in reality, only half of it is drawn every frame. Since the vertical resolution doubles, but the screen stays the same size, this makes the picture seem to squish vertically to fit in the screen. Now, in the horizontal direction, normally there are 256 dots per scan line. In the pseudo-horizontal 512 mode, the subscreen is shifted a half dot to the right of the main subscreen, and the color math functionality is used to merge the two. This creates an image that actually has 512 dots per scan line. But, since the way graphics get drawn is kind of convoluted and not what you would expect, this is called pseudo for a reason. However, modes 5 and 6 actually have a true horizontal resolution of 512 dots, no fancy shifting or anything. Just like the interlaced mode, since the horizontal resolution doubles but the screen stays the same size, the picture seems to squish to fit. Horizontal 512 mode and interlaced mode can be enabled simultaneously to produce an image that is 512 by 448 pixels in size. The largest resolution the SNES will output is actually 512 by 478. This is by enabling overscan mode, which is used by default in the PAL region.